Divorce can be a difficult and complicated topic to talk about, but it is essential to learn about its rules before making the decision to get one. Today, we are going to discuss one of the biggest subject areas in a divorce, marital property division. Welcome to Miles Mason Family Law. Is the state of Tennessee a 50-50 state for divorce? For purposes of marital property division law in divorce, Tennessee is an equitable distribution state. It's not a 50-50 state, not a community property state, not an equal division state. In the 9 community property states, each spouse has a 50% ownership interest in the marital estate. Community property jurisdictions are often called 50-50 divorce states because they divide marital estates equally between the spouses. In Tennessee divorce law, an equitable property division isn't always equal, but it can be. Typically, there are 2 ways the parties can achieve a 50-50 property division. The judge decides, or the parties agree to it. Tennessee, like other dual property states, recognizes 2 property classifications, marital and separate. Only marital property is divided in divorce. An equitable distribution must fairly allocate marital assets and debts between the spouses. What the court deems fair could be an equal or near equal division, or not. It could be 40-60, 25-75, or some other split that is fair and equitable, yet unequal. In determining who gets what, Tennessee courts are required to consider numerous legal factors before making a final distribution. The factors are listed in Tennessee Code Annotated Section 36-4-121C. They include the duration of the marriage, the age, physical and mental health, vocational skills, employability, earning capacity, estate, financial liabilities, and financial needs of each of the parties, the tangible or intangible contribution by one party to the education, training, or increased earning power of the other party, the relative ability of each party for future acquisitions of capital assets and income, the contribution of each party to the acquisition, preservation, appreciation, depreciation, or dissipation of the marital or separate property, including the contribution of a party to the marriage as homemaker, wage earner, or parent, with the contribution of a party as homemaker or wage earner to be given the same weight if each party has fulfilled its role, the value of the separate property of each party, the estate of each party at the time of the marriage, the economic circumstances of each party at the time the division of property is to become effective, the tax consequences to each party, costs associated with the reasonably foreseeable sale of the asset, and other reasonably foreseeable expenses associated with the asset. In determining the value of an interest in a closely held business or similar asset, all relevant evidence, including valuation methods typically used with regard to such assets, without regard to whether the sale of the asset is reasonably foreseeable. Depending on the characteristics of the asset, such considerations could include, but would not be limited to, a lack of marketability discount, a discount for lack of control, and a control premium, if any should be relevant and supported by the evidence, the amount of Social Security benefits available to each spouse, and such other factors as are necessary to consider the equities between the parties. Family law judges have broad discretion in balancing the equities when dividing marital property. How Tennessee judges go about dividing marital property will vary. Most judges begin with a 50-50 division, making adjustments up or down from there. Equitable distribution of the entire marital estate is accomplished with each party receiving what the court deems to be a fair share of their assets and debts. In determining an equitable debt division, the court applies a 4-factor analysis. 1. The purpose of the debt. 2. Which spouse incurred the debt? 3. Which spouse benefits or benefited from the debt? 4. And which spouse is best able to repay the debt? Typically, a property settlement is negotiated as part of the party's marital dissolution agreement, or MDA. Spouses who want their marital property divided equally, 50-50, can agree to it in writing as part of their MDA. Of the ways to achieve a 50-50 division, The least predictable is leaving it to the judge to decide. Mason's divorce tip. Depending on the particular assets and debts in a marital estate to be divided in divorce, family lawyers should almost always create a marital balance sheet on a spreadsheet listing all assets and debts. Variances in asset valuation, such as real estate or businesses, should be considered in divorce financial analysis. When negotiating a property division in divorce, a divorcing party should want to know, and not guess, the relative percentage of the net marital estate each spouse will receive in the proposed settlement. We hope this video has helped you with identifying that Tennessee is not a 50-50 state, but an equitable distribution one, as well as the rules and factors that apply with being an equitable distribution state. To learn more, visit memphisdivorce.com, Tennessee's most comprehensive free online family law legal resource. MemphisDivorce.com answers hundreds of frequently asked questions on divorce, alimony, property division, custody, and more, with videos and hosts our Tennessee Family Law blog. Check out Miles Mason's author page on Amazon.com. He is the author of 3 books, including the Tennessee Divorce Clients Handbook, now available on audiobook and Kindle. Discover all you can learn with Miles Mason Family Law.